Welcome back to Racing Rundown. On today's video, we are going to be previewing another of the Kentucky Derby starters. As you can tell by the title, we're going to be talking about Confidence Game, winner of the Rebel Stakes at Oaklawn Park back on February 25th. However, before we get any further, I will mention there is a playlist in the description below where you can check out the other Kentucky Derby profiles on Racing Rundown that we will be producing across the week. At the point of recording this, we're about halfway through the profiles, give or take. I'm expecting to have most of these done by the end of the week, with the exception of one or two, give or take. So with that being said, we'll get into talking about Confidence Game. Seven career starts going into the Kentucky Derby. He's won three races. And an important thing for him, and we'll get to this a little bit later when we get into the pros and the cons, but this is a horse who has experience at Churchill Downs. He broke his maiden on the Arlington Million card on August 13th at Churchill Downs, going six furlongs. But he has he has abundant two-turn experience. However, he has not run farther than a mile and a 16th in his career, but his last five starts going into, or his last five starts, including that win in the Rebel, have all been at a mile and a 16th. So this horse does have ample two-turn experience, although I will further, as you can tell by the title screen, talk about the issues that he has going into this. But outside of that win on August 13th in the Churchill Downs maiden race, he ran in the Iroquois, and he probably wasn't ready to go two turns on that day. He was fifth in that spot, beaten behind Jace's Road, among other horses, and Jace's Road, a subsequent winner on the Kentucky Derby prep scene. But continued, stayed the course with trainer Keith DeSormo, went to Keeneland, ran second in October in a mile and a 16th allowance, and then he won. I already referenced this allowance when I talked about Hit Show, and I believe Eric also referenced it when he talked about Rocket Can, but it was race 8 on November 26th, the Stars of Tomorrow card at Churchill Downs, and that was the very salty allowance that featured those horses that I mentioned, and Confidence Game was actually the winner of that race. And then he siphoned that into a run in the LeCompte, where he ran third, but he ran third behind two solid horses, although that being mentioned, he was beaten 7 3/4 lengths, so beaten almost 8 lengths there, but a decent group of horses who ran in that spot. Again, I think Instant Coffee is a lot better than his Louisiana Derby effort would advertise, and I think he would be in the Kentucky Derby if he had run in the Risen Star, but that's not something that we're going to get into here. And also worth mentioning, Dennington bounced out of the Risen Star to win an allowance race in nice fashion as well. So some good back class to Confidence Game that he has going into, not even just going into the Rebel, just throughout his career. And that's one of the pros that I'll get into a little bit more later, is he has good back class throughout his career. And then we get to the biggest win of his career, and that was, of course, the Rebel Stakes at Oaklawn, where he beat Red Route 1, who just last weekend took out the Oaklawn, or what used to be the Oaklawn Invitational, is now called the Bathhouse Row Stakes, but that is a race that features a winning your in berth for the Preakness. And Confidence Game finished in front of several other nice horses in that race. Red Route 1, I mentioned. Reincarnate won the Sham. Verifying ran Tapitrice as much as he could in the Bluegrass, eventually finishing second there. So the Rebel had some good horses in it, and Confidence Game was the winner of that race in a fairly decisive length fashion there. Now, that being said, one of the benefits that he had of running in the Rebel was he got some pace in front of him. And this is a horse that I don't think is as much of a deep, deep closer as he is maybe one of those third flight horses. There's a lot of horses that are going to be sitting in that third flight, though. So I would wonder if Confidence Game will be toward the back of that third flight group as opposed to in the middle or towards the front of the third flight group. And I'm not talking about the race. I'm talking specifically that third flight group in this year's Kentucky Derby. And that's a concern that I've seen some people bring up about Confidence Game, is that he's probably going to need at least something in front of him. And this isn't a Derby that we're forecasting to have a lot of early foot in. So that's something that Confidence Game and the other closers are going to have to contend with. But he had a nice stretch of races going into the Rebel. You know, the LeCompte certainly leaves a lot to be desired, but at least he finished in front of horses that are graded stakes caliber, and Two Fills is coming off of a career-best effort. So we'll get into the pros and cons, or actually, before we get to the pros and cons with him, we'll take a look at the figures, and throughout the early portion of his career, very pedestrian, but he improved vastly from his allowance race at Keeneland, where he was assessed as 64, moved up to an 83, so that's almost a 20-point increase. So certainly improved very well there, dropped a little bit into the LeCompte, but stayed around the same course, and then he improved 14-fold from the LeCompte into the Rebel, where he got a 94 there, which was among the best of the February prep winners there, and he was a horse that I would have given serious thought to if he had run in a final prep, but he's not. He did not run in a final prep, and he's going right to the Kentucky Derby from the Rebel. And one more thing that I will mention about the Rebel is Keith DeSormo talked about the win after the race and was saying that he wasn't really sure how he was going to run in the race because he kind of brought him to the Rebel, and he wasn't sure how he was going to run in that spot. So be that as it may, you can do with that information what you will, but you know, you could take a positive view of that and say, okay, well, if the trainer didn't think coming into the race that he was going to run a good race there, and then he turns in a winning effort, then that's certainly something that isn't a negative. You could also look at it in the fact of, okay, well, he didn't know what he was doing going into the Rebel. Maybe he doesn't know what he's doing going into the Kentucky Derby. So you can attack that from both ends of the spectrum there. We'll get to the pros and cons now, and I already referenced this a little bit, but the Rebel was a huge step forward for him, especially from the allowance race that he ran at Churchill Downs. It was an 11-point improvement up to the 94, so that's obviously something that you like to see. We haven't gotten to see an opportunity, to see him progress further from that, but if he's going to progress, he doesn't even have to progress 11 points further, but if he's going to progress even marginally, a 2-3 point improvement, at least on a buyer standpoint, that makes him at least a contender in this year's Kentucky Derby. So the Rebel, from a performance standpoint, was certainly a step forward. But if you're a speed figure person, I'm not the biggest speed figure person, but if you love your speed figures, even if it's like a 2 or 3 point improvement off of the Rebel, that makes him a player in this year's Kentucky Derby. He's also won on multiple occasions at Churchill Downs. He's the most experienced horse over this surface here. He's run four times at Churchill Downs. He's won twice and then has stakes efforts there twice. So I like to, when I can, get the opportunity to see horses that have runs at Churchill Downs in their careers. So I think that that's something that's certainly positive for him. When you get the efforts over Churchill Downs, that's something that I like to see. And good backlash throughout his career. I mentioned the horses that came out of the Rebel to run good races. Red Route 1, subsequent stakes winner next out. Reincarnate, who was third there. Stakes placed in the Arkansas Derby. Verifying. I already mentioned Ran Tappet tries to a very close second there. You go back to LeCompte. Two Fills comes out of that. Goes and turns in his effort that he did in the Jeff Ruby. And even as I mentioned, Instant Coffee, who isn't everybody's favorite horse, I still think Instant Coffee is a nice three-year-old, and I think that he could have been here in the Kentucky Derby. And even you go back to that allowance race, Hit Show and Rocket Can were all stakes winners. So good back class overall from his races. Now, I've been saying a lot of positive things about Confidence Game, but now I'm going to get into the negatives. And his last prep race was at a mile and a 16th. And a horse has not won the Kentucky Derby with their final prep being a mile and a 16th since Charismatic won the Derby in 1999. But there was something important about Charismatic that Confidence Game does not have. Charismatic had experience at a mile and an eighth. And I don't know the last time that there's been a horse that has won the Kentucky Derby without experience at the mile and an eighth in his final prep into the Kentucky Derby. It has to have been a long time ago if it even happened, but nothing as of late to go on that front. So that's a big, I think, negative and handicap that he's going to have going into this Kentucky Derby, is he doesn't have the experience at a mile and an eighth, which most of these other horses do have. So that's certainly something that I will point out as a negative that he has going into the Kentucky Derby. He's also entering off of a 9-week layoff, and the longest that a horse has had off going into the Kentucky Derby was the 6-week layoff that Barbaro had going into the Kentucky Derby. And excuse me, it was the 6-week layoff that Animal Kingdom had from the Spiral going into the, or what was then the Spiral, what's now the Jeff Ruby, going into the Kentucky Derby. Barbaro was a 5-week layoff at that point when he won the Kentucky Derby. It was a record, but 6 weeks is the longest time between Kentucky Derby, or between final prep and Derby win. You're adding an extra 3 weeks for confidence game. He hasn't run in 2 months, and this is where we get into the unorthodox workout schedule. He hasn't worked since the 14th, which some people have been raising alarm bells about, but he breezed from the gate for a mile at Churchill Downs on October 14th, which I was talking to Eric about this, and Eric said that that was kind of a de facto race for him. So I'm not super concerned about the lack of works going into the Kentucky Derby, because this is a horse that didn't have a final prep. So it makes sense that he was going to get a sort of long workout going into the Kentucky Derby, but it's very unorthodox and not something that you would typically see from a horse. Now, Keith DeSormo is the type of trainer that has done this before in situations, so be that as it may, Keith DeSormo is one of the few people that I would at least give even a thought to taking a horse of his seriously with this kind of a strategy, but it's still very unorthodox and something that I wouldn't be too comfortable with. So he breaks a couple of my big rules. You got to have a start at a mile and an eighth going into the Kentucky Derby for me to view you as a legitimate win contender, and the big time off between his final prep and the Kentucky Derby start. I think the 9 weeks is really going to hamper him. I would have liked to have seen him get a final prep in. I think he makes a lot of sense. You can make a case for him to win the Kentucky Derby. I don't think he's as crazy as some other people might think he is, because there is upside to him. But the upside comes with so many other added questions that he's a horse that I will likely be looking against Kentucky Derby Day. With that being said, that's going to be it for this preview. Be sure to check out some of the other previews that we have linked below in the description, and we will see you next time on Racing Rundown. Have a good one.